Yo, what's up? This is JC, your boy right here. What I got right here is an ASUS ROG Strike G15 Advantage Edition. This comes with 512 GB of storage, which you can expand to up to 8 TB. So you got an additional storage port. It's Gen 3, so Gen 4 won't work so well. So don't try to put a Gen 4 because it won't work so well. So it also comes with 16 GB of RAM, and it's a dual channel. So each RAM slot is 8 and they're not soldered in. You can upgrade the RAM up to 64 gigabits of RAM. So that's awesome. It comes with 11 screws, 4 on the bottom, 4 in the middle, 3 in the middle, and 4 on top. And it's easy to expand. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm just gonna screw it down and upgrade the storage. And the ones I'm gonna be using right here is a Patriot 32 gigabits PC 4 3200 megahertz CLL 1.2V. So the RAM speed on this particular laptop is 3200 megahertz. So you gotta buy the right one, the right speed to match it, or there may be problems. So that's it. Like I said, they got a Patriot signature line 3200. So I'm gonna boost it up to 64 gigabits of RAM, and I got me my PCI. This is a Gen 3, 1 TB SSD. So I got my 2 screwdrivers right here. It's a regular Phillips with a magnet tip. And I got this small one right here. Small right here for the screws. All right, so let's get into it. I'm gonna flip it over, expose in the back. See, you got the screws right here in the bottom, middle, and the back. All right. Let's upgrade the storage real quick. Out of this PC, all 4 screws out, as you can see. Now, if you got something flat to get in between these grooves right here to pop it up, that's fine. Like a guitar pick or something flat to go underneath it, that's fine. Or if you got fingernails, because I don't got much, you can simply go in between the groove and pop it and slowly open the sides. It's very simple, which I'm gonna show you real quick. So let's do this real quick. Can you see me? Okay, nice and easy. And this bad boy, it got a ribbon for the LED, for the RGB lights. You gotta be very careful. Take your time, pop it. And now what I do, I'll just gently slide it. You see, these ribbons right here, they're for the LED, for the RGB lights. You gotta be very careful, because if you pull it, you can break it. So you gotta be very gentle. So you can see the internals right here. I'm gonna slide over some more so you can see. All right. Now you can see this got the liquid cooling chamber right here. These are the heat pipes, which is awesome. Let's scroll it down some more so you can see. And these are the fans. These are the fans for the CPU and the GPU. And these right here, let me come back out a little bit. This right here is for the RAM. And this is the SSD that comes with it, 512 gigabits. And this is right here. Let me go right show you. This is the extra space we could include your SSD in to boost up the storage. And this is a thermal, it's like a thermal paste or thermal paper, like it's very thick. So I'm gonna gently remove it and show you guys. Be very gentle with this thing. Boom. See? Got a nice adhesive. And very thick. Just like a heat shield for the RAM. And what you want to do before you remove the RAM from the before you move the RAM, you want to disconnect the power from the battery. So I can scroll in. Boom, show right here. So this is the battery cable. You got to disconnect it first, like this. Slide it up. I'll pop it out. All right. So you got the battery disconnected. First thing first, good. And to remove the RAMs, it's very easy. Just pull these clips at the side, like this. Boom. And then just remove them. Just that simple. This is the RAM right here for the that comes with your Asus Strix G15 Advantage Edition. That's the first one. And the second one is just as easy. Just pull the clips and boom, it's out. Good. So right here, underneath here is a Wi-Fi card. It's by MediaTek. I'll go right here so I can show you. It's underneath right here. Underneath the SSD is a Wi-Fi card. It's a Wi-Fi 6 by MediaTek. I don't know if it's exchangeable. I may give it a try later. So let's do this first. Let's expand the storage. Let's expand the storage for the Asus Strix. So I'm gonna use my what did I do wrong? So I'm gonna use my screwdriver. It's a regular Phillips right here. So I'll show you. This one with the magnetic tip, because these screws are very small. I'm gonna screw this down. So the magnet tips, so small screws. Let's get out here. So small screws. So boom. So I'm just gonna put it to the side, and then you just slide in the SSD card just like this. Very simple. Boom. Just slide it in. So you can raise up a little bit. Now you're just gonna screw this bad boy down. Very simple. Alright. Take it down. Perfect. And if you want to know if this can be removed, yes, you can remove it. But what you got to make sure you do, whatever you get, whenever you get a new SSD, you got to be a Gen 3. And all the operating system, the OS, is going to be C in the disk management. It's going to be disk C in the disk management, and it's going to say OS. You got to clone it first. You can use Macrium to clone it onto your external before. Because if you just remove it and just put any SSD inside of it, it's gonna go into the BIOS screen. You can get out the BIOS screen, but you're gonna keep on going back into there because it's not reading the operating system. So you gotta clone the operating system off of it onto a SSD and put it in here, and then it will work. All right, so let's get the Patriot. We get the Patriot RAM right here, and I'll set it inside the RAM port. Let's show you right here, the Patriot. Made in Taiwan, and it's very simple to do. Just slide it in and just clip it, boom, just like that. Very simple. Let's go right here. So now let me get the second one. Got right here my second Patriot RAM. I'll slide it in. You could pull a ribbon if you want, but me, I don't pull a ribbon. I just gently just slide it over to the side. I'm gonna open this clip a little bit. Okay, nice and easy. Oops, slipped it on my hands. Boom, slip, click, just like that. Very simple. Now, what we're gonna do first thing first, before you power this bad boy on, you gotta to drain the power from the motherboard. You're gonna put your finger on the power button. This is what they usually do. Very simple. Just turn it around nice and gentle. You don't have to do it like me, but this is what I do. To get all the juice out of the motherboard. Okay, let me get mold here. It's too far out. What you gotta do to drain the juice out of the motherboard, gonna hold on to the power button for at least 30 seconds to drain the power from the motherboard. I think that's enough. So I'm gonna flip it back over onto the back. Like I said, if you got decent fingernails, you can just simply go into the corners, nice and easy. You can slide it off, but you got to be very gentle because you don't want to rip the RGB cable that's inside of there. Let's do it for more support. I'm sorry. Okay, so just gently pop it. Boom, easy. So what we're gonna do next? This is what we do next. We're gonna slide it up. You gotta connect the. Let me go right here. Show you quick. We're gonna connect the battery cable back onto it. It's as simple as just snap it back on. Just snap. Nice and gentle, and just slide the clip back onto it, and it's fine. And now what we're gonna do? We're gonna screw this bad boy back in, and then we're gonna power it on. So here we go, just gonna snap it. Make sure we go all the way to the other sides. Snap, everything snap into place. Boom, boom, boom. All right, good. Everything is snapped evenly onto place. All right, good. So now we're gonna put the screws back, and then we're gonna power this bad boy on. Oh, I forgot to put back the thermal, the heat shield for the, I forgot to put the heat shield onto the RAM. But let me just unscrew this bad boy back real quick. I almost forgot. All right, this is what I forgot to do. I forgot to put back these heat shield thick paper thingy on for the RAM to prevent it from overheating or burning up, whatever you want to call it. And the adhesive is strong. All you gotta do is slide it back on. Boom, just like that. See, slide it back on. And voila, just like that. Now, let's screw this bad boy up back one more time. Make sure it's easy as clip. Snap, snap, snap. Make sure that everything's snapped on correctly. Boom. All right, so let me just do a reverse. Let me just do it in reverse this time. I'm just start screwing from the back.
Don't over-screw it, just keep the knife with a screw, like a finger tight, but not too tight. Good. Just enough. And now I'm going to turn the bad boy around, open the middle and the front. It's right here, the RAM. Let's do the front first, these screws. Now for the easy one, right in the middle. Okay. Boom. Boom. Boom, just like that.
As you can see, these are the old ones that come with it. Boom. And I got a Patriot Elite inside. So let me flip it over. Kind of dusty. Now, let's just see what I can do right here. Let me flip this bad boy over. I'll adjust my camera a little bit. All right, let me power this bad boy and see what we got. Takes a little time, don't worry, but that's what it does. That's why you have to disconnect the battery. So it's fine. should be up. It should be up and running in a minute now. It's doing its thing. Here we go. When you see it does that, and you see that little thing spinning around, that means everything's perfect. Good, everything's working just fine. Let me show right here, this particular one, ASUS that I have right here, the Strikes. This will be the Radeon 6800, what I got here. So everything is working perfectly fine. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna put in my password. And then I'm gonna go into the crate so you can see for yourself. Boot the crate up. So get out of there. Boom. So if you could look, let me scroll down. You see right there for the RAM, I got 63.4 gigabits of RAM left, and only 5.9 gigabits of RAM is in use. And you can see right here for the storage. I got 378.6 used, and I got 1,387 gigabits of storage left. So what I'm gonna do in my next video, I'm gonna do the upload speed test to see which one is faster with the stock compared to the upgraded version. And then in the next video after that, I may do a cloning from the stock SSD that's inside onto another one to show you how the procedure works. All right, so you can see right here, the wattage is perfectly fine. It's 3200 megahertz right here. See, memory frequency, 3200 megahertz. And the RAM, 64. And the storage, it's basically like 15. But you already do the math after you take away everything. And it's now running at a temperature between 50, in the 50s, which is not bad. It's running on battery powered right now. Very simple. All right, thanks for tuning in. This is your boy JC. It's like a fumble in the video because whatever, but at least you guys see how you can upgrade the storage onto your ASUS Strix G15 Advanced Edition. You can bump it up to 64, and you can bump it up the SSD, the storage up to, I think it's 8 terabytes. So this is how you do it. So thanks for tuning in. Feel free to subscribe, like the channel, and appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.